Hi, this is Mariko Passion. This is the birthday hangover edition of the Home Strip Club Network. This is the secret to my daily workout as well, besides buying those little mirrors. I actually had the mirrors for my show, but just simply buying a jump rope because my gym is actually 45 minutes away, so sometimes I don't have time to go all the way down there. So my first goal was to weigh 136 by the time I turned 36, which was yesterday. But I pushed it to 135. I thought I could weigh 135, but today, I didn't even know. You wanna come to the bathroom? Let's go to the bathroom. Let's see what I'm weighing in today. This is the birthday edition. We have a digital scale. And this is the, you know, see how the, whoa, what's that say? 134, baby, that's 1 pound more than what I thought I could ever achieve. I haven't lost any weight in 6 years. I haven't been on a diet in 6 years. I gained 12 to 15 pounds in the last 6 years. And I just really had lost hope that it was, not really lost hope, it's kind of interesting. I had just given up on the fact that I could ever lose weight. You actually had given up on yourself. You really did believe that what other people said about your body was something that you had to learn to accept. I really did not believe that it was possible for me to lose any weight at all, which is crazy. I wonder how many people have that, you know, idea that it's impossible for you to lose weight. So I don't have the weight that I, my dream weight or whatever is to be at the same weight that I was when I was in my 20s, and that's like in the 20s, like 128. I'm currently 134, which is like the leanest I've ever been and that I can remember. Definitely, you know, I just, you know, I'm so thankful because I've exceeded my expectations and I'm riding that wave still, and it's just, I'm thankful for the bone, you know, kind of like, oh, thank God it worked out. Because the rewards are more than your body. It's like you feel better, you know? Like, if it doesn't work out between me and people I date, I don't trip at all. It just kind of flows through me. I don't care if they call or not. I don't care if nobody's with me in Palm Springs. It's fine. Yeah. I took martial arts 3 to 4 times a week. And I wasn't losing weight. But the reason why I wasn't losing weight is because I would eat plates of noodles 3 times a week, late at night. I would go to Del Taco sometimes because I work late at night and that's the only thing that was open. I get really stoned, go eat, you know? And that's kind of the lifestyle that I was leading, even though I was working out pretty hard 3 times a week. But here's the secret to the success is on the whiteboard here. Basically, I upped my workouts to daily, or at least 5 to 6 times a week. It's my birthday week and I'm going to Palm Springs, so I'm not gonna be that regimented, but I am gonna be on the treadmill. I wanna go into my diet. I'm in a motel room for 4 days, but I have my spinach. I didn't have time to, I usually make a dressing with this stuff, flax oil. I have cooked salmon because there's no hot plate here. My very limited dairy, which is goat cheese that I use in my salads. But kind of what it takes to be healthy is a ton of supplements. I take CLA and GLA. I milk thistle for digestion. So packing is a son of a bitch because I have to take all of my supplements, the oil you put in your salad every day. These are psyllium husks, and you put that in your cranberry juice twice a day. And then you take these supplements. I was really someone who resisted anything daily. I was like, fuck doing anything daily. I can't take the birth control every day. I just refused. I basically just refused to do anything every day, even if it benefited me. It was hard for me. I would do it for a week or 2 weeks or whatever, and then I wouldn't do it anymore. So I finally, something just kicked in and I was like, what does it look like to do it every day and just give it a try? And if I try something like lose weight and get fit every day, then what will the results be? And these are the results. So I'm pretty happy with the results, and my mental
state has really improved. Depression is sort of a faint memory. I never get depressed because I'm always exercising. Excuse my charisma, vodka with a spritzer, swagger down pat, call my shit Patricia, young money militia, and I am the commissioner. You don't want Star Weezy cause the F is for finisher. So misunderstood, but what's the world without enigma? Two bitches at the same time, synchronized swimmers. Got the girl twisted cause she open when you twist her. Never met the bitch, but I fuck her like I missed her. Life is the bitch, and death is her sister. Sleep is the cousin, what a fucking family picture. You know father time, and we all know mother nature. It's all in the family, but I am of no relation. No matter who's buying, I'm a celebration. Black and white diamonds, fuck segregation. Fuck that shit.
That's why I'm doing the strip club workout, because I perform on stage and I didn't want to be winded, and I want to look the best that I could possibly look. Like, what does that take for me to, you know, have the stamina to sing and dance for 30, 45 minutes? It takes a lot out of you breath-wise and body-wise. So if you notice, I'm like, at first it was a joke. The last video, it was a total joke, but I was seriously sick of people, clients, even students that I've taught, they would ask me if I was pregnant. So I had this pregnant stomach, and people would be like, no, you don't look pregnant, but lots of people say I look pregnant. And now I can see like the side definition of like my six pack information, and that motivates me, especially like when I do a burpee. I have to show a burpee. This is for you, Nancy. Okay, a burpee, you go on your stomach, and then... So I've done 140 of those in a row, but when I do burpees and I go in the mirror, I can see my stomach, and that motivates me to do more burpees. I look good standing up. I don't really care very much about stripper heels as I used to, because I've been dancing in front of the mirror for, I don't do it every day because sometimes I'm too busy. So, but I've been dancing in front of the mirror enough to know that I'm sexy. You know, that I'm sexy even without the stripper shoes. So we're gonna go over some of the moves that I've been doing in my apartment strip club. So sometimes you can't go to the gym and you have your whole apartment, you have your living room. I just spot these $9.99 Target mirrors, and I just like, you know, make sure. So one of the moves that I do is this, I just make sure that I do this hip rotation thing in a circle all the way down to the ground. And if you do that 10 fucking times, your whole body is burning. And then I do big hip circles. You can make an 8. And then if you do that 8 thing, it kind of forms the oblique, so it hits that area. Back to the ground. And then the other move that I do, this one. Like, I try to stay at this angle, and I move in and out 10 to 15 times. I want a six pack. One of my goals for my birthday was to get a six pack, and it's almost there. I think on Monday I'm gonna start taking CrossFit Elements, which is the beginner training course for CrossFit, and I quit CrossFit because it was too hard, and I don't like too hard. I like it to be fun and a good workout, but I'm willing to go the extra mile. So I'm gonna try it again. And then I might take other activities, like pole dancing and cardio bar classes, like different ways to like get the soul moving, which is basically what strip club stripping, you know, is. And that's kind of what I was reinforcing with the strip club workout.